This is ABC7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
We have to be very careful. We're just trying not to go out when we don't need to.
You feel like you're living in hiding?
Sometimes, yeah.
Escaping violence in Mexico, a family found new hope in the land of the free and right here on the Suncoast. Tonight, we'll share their story with you and hear from voices calling for enforcement of immigration law. Good evening, everyone. I'm Alan Cohen, and welcome to ABC 7 at 7. Our exclusive interview with that family is coming up, but first, our top 7 stories at 7. And we begin tonight in Sarasota, where Governor Rick Scott is continuing his offensive against fellow Republicans who are trying to cut off support for Visit Florida and Enterprise Florida. The governor calls both organizations essential to job creation. He is also asking voters to call their legislators who voted for defunding the agencies. Last week, the Florida House voted to eliminate Enterprise Florida and slash money to Visit Florida. The House Speaker calls it corporate welfare.
The people who go to the theater, who go to Van Wezel, who go to Oslo, they'll be all going to California. The high-spending visitors are the ones we'll lose first.
But we need to reach out to Jim Boyd, Julio Gonzalez, and Alex Miller to make sure we keep jobs going in the state.
Venice Republican Julio Gonzalez, who voted to cut funding to the agency, says Enterprise Florida has produced misleading data and has not led to any local job growth since it was created in 2011. Governor Scott is also launching a new TV ad targeting fellow Republicans over the state's job and tourism marketing agencies. The spot airs statewide starting next week. It features Governor Scott warning that Tallahassee politicians don't get it. Scott also says their votes to shutter the state's economic development agency and overhaul Visit Florida will cost the state jobs. The ad is being paid for by Let's Get to Work, a political committee controlled by Scott. Now to Palmetto, where a 15-year-old boy is dead after being hit by a car on his way to school. State troopers say Marcarios Kelly was crossing the intersection at U.S. 41 and 23rd Street East this morning when he was struck. Apparently, the driver had the green light and didn't see Kelly on the busy road. The driver reportedly stopped immediately and tried to help. Kelly's family says there needs to be changes made to the intersection to keep this from happening again.
I feel like they should have some kind of cross guard or a caution light to slow down traffic. If that would have been possible, that wouldn't have never happened.
They need an overpass for those kids to come across that road, especially if they're not going to provide school bus for them.
Kelly was a sophomore at Palmetto High School. Grief counselors will remain on campus for students and teachers. Now to the community of Laurel in South Sarasota County, where a man is facing multiple charges of animal abuse. Sheriff's deputies are arresting 46-year-old Ivan McCullum after 14 malnourished dogs were found locked in cages at his home. The dogs are being treated for a range of illnesses, including heartworms and hookworms.
There was a dog in the front yard that was tethered without proper water and shelter. And then there was some other dogs that were being kept in metal crates.
There's really no excuse for that. And you wonder about the mentality of the person who does that.
Authorities say the dogs are expected to recover. McCullum is facing multiple counts of animal cruelty. Now for an update on a former Sarasota County Sheriff's deputy accused of attempted murder. Frank Bybee appeared in court today. He faces 20 charges for allegedly befriending an elderly woman, stealing her money, and trying to kill her. Bybee did not speak at today's hearing, but he has two new lawyers and a new felony charge involving the illegal use of computer systems. He is pleading not guilty. The Sarasota Police Department is hoping to expand its fleet of golf carts. The Downtown Improvement District recently gave the police department a $9,000 grant to buy this street legal golf cart. It is gas powered and includes seat belts and turn signals. Volunteer ambassadors with SPD use the golf cart to patrol neighborhoods like Gillespie Park, the Rosemary District, and Burns Court. We often hear how jobs in manufacturing are disappearing. Well, State College of Florida is partnering with phosphate giant Mosaic to prepare more students for new high-tech careers in manufacturing. According to SCF's president, Manatee has a major shortage in workers trained for advanced manufacturing. Mosaic has been working with the college for 2 years to design a new curriculum to change that. The company is also donating more than $350,000 to enhance SCF's engineering technology program.
Also, it's about internships, working with Mosaic so that these students have those real-world experiences while they're going through the courses, which will make them better employees when they graduate.
We have an aging workforce. We know that we're going to have a significant number of retirees over the next few years. But the other part of it is when we think about global competition.
Mosaic employs nearly 4,000 people in Manatee County. Its new two-year program will debut at SCF this fall. Bob, as for the weather, it's been so cold. It's been real, it's been nice, but it's not been real nice. Take it away.
We are looking for nicer weather on St. Patrick's Day. We'll get a little bit of the luck of the Irish as temperatures will start to warm back close to average. We will have a cold night tonight, though, Alan. We're looking for low temperatures to be about 5 degrees warmer than this morning's lows, which were in the 30s, but it will still be rather chilly. And looking at the nice time lapse of the Van Wezel webcam over Sarasota Bay, not a cloud in the sky, and it looks like it'll stay that way too overnight. Currently, the humidity is really low. Right now, it's at 35%. The temperature, though, is dropping, 58. Clear skies, winds out of the northwest, north-northwest at 10 now, and the pressure continues to rise at 30, 29. The evening forecast calling for temperatures to drop into the upper 40s by 11 o'clock. Clear skies anticipated, and it looks as though we will see a warm-up, as I mentioned, tomorrow. 58 degrees now in Sarasota. It's 63 in Orlando. 1 degree warmer in Miami City, Northport at 65, and 62 in Inglewood, or 63 in Inglewood, 62 at Manasota Key. Winds out of the west-northwest, a little stronger near the beaches. Siesta Key at 13, and Northport now seeing an 11-mile-an-hour wind out of the north, making it feel all that much colder. No real warnings for us as far as the cold goes, but a high fire danger exists as a result of that low humidity.
Even with the rain the other day.
Yeah, it's pretty much gone, evaporated. So we'll stay in that high fire danger for a while.
All right, thanks a lot, Bob. And still to come, they made the dangerous journey across the border, and now they are proud to call the Suncoast home. But it was only recently that they received any type of documentation. When we return, we'll introduce you to a family that illegally immigrated in our exclusive interview.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC7. We're here for you.
Attention blood clot filter patients. Surgically implanted blood clot filters are potentially life-threatening. Some filters are prone to breaking, resulting in pieces of the filter moving through the body and causing internal bleeding. If you had surgery to implant a blood clot filter, you may be entitled to a cash award, even if you haven't suffered side effects yet. Call the Gold Shield Group now, 888-747-5291, to see if you qualify for a cash award. 888-747-5291.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
It's no small wonder anybody loves it all.
I just love art that moves me.
No smile.
I mean, really moves me.
Why?
Sunset Fiat of Sarasota presents No Small Wonder, high performance style. Let the art of Fiat move you.
You only have one life. Are you gambling with it? One in three adults have high blood pressure. Not knowing your numbers could cause you to lose big time. Luckily, you can turn the odds in your favor by getting your blood pressure checked today. Don't leave your health to chance. Learn more at heart.org/HPB.
President Trump is putting your money where his mouth is when it comes to a crackdown on illegal immigration. $2.8 billion. While many Trump supporters are pleased, you can imagine what the reaction is among those who now are in fear of what's to come. Kate Flexter joins us with more. Kate.
Thanks, Alan. Tonight, we're hearing from one family that came to America from Mexico illegally in an ABC 7 exclusive.
When you're just trying to have a better life, you'll do anything.
For this illegal immigrant couple, seeking that better life brought them from crime-ridden Mexico City to the United States, a journey that involved a three-day walk across the desert.
It was tough. We couldn't see our feet. Well, we have to walk.
And you said people would die in the desert and just, they would leave them.
You have to leave them.
Now they've been here for about 20 years and recently received a visa only after cooperating with law enforcement when their home was robbed. Even still, the fear of deportation weighs heavy.
We have to be very careful. We're just trying not to go out when we don't need to.
Do you feel like you're living in hiding?
Sometimes, yeah.
It's just one story of millions like it. In 2014, Pew Research reported 11.1 million illegal immigrants in the United States, many of them hiding in plain sight. And it's those statistics President Donald Trump hopes to change, from talks of building a wall to recently released documents from Homeland Security calling for a crackdown on illegal immigration. The president has promised to tighten border security, accusing illegal immigrants of stealing American jobs and increasing crime rates.
For the first time, we're getting gang members out, we're getting drug lords out, we're getting really bad dudes out of this country.
Trump is not the first president to crack down on illegal immigration. According to data from the Department of Homeland Security, President George W. Bush's administration deported just over 2 million illegal immigrants during his time in office. And President Barack Obama's administration deported 2.5 million, excluding his last year in office, as data is not yet available. That's more than any other administration. Psychologist Dr. Daniel Van Engen says deportations have led to a sort of mass hysteria.
This fear of deportation is a real issue that's affecting a lot of families.
Van Engen specializes in stress and anxiety and for 6 years has traveled to schools around the country speaking to counselors and school nurses about the major stressors students face. For the first time, he says fear of deportation emerged as a top concern.
Nurses I've talked to have reported increased numbers of these types of symptoms among families who don't have legal documentation.
He says for many, it's the uncertainty and lack of control that causes anxiety.
If life is based on the roll of a dice, flip of the coin, getting on the canoe and going whichever way the current takes you, you tend to have more anxiety and fear.
Deportations or otherwise, CEO and president of Protect U.S. Workers, Sarah Blackwell, says America is in need of a solution to the issue of undocumented workers.
I think the raids are a harsh thing. It's a harsh thing, but something has to be done. Either they need to give them rights or they need to make them leave.
Blackwell defends American workers and argues they simply cannot compete for jobs with the often exploited undocumented workers.
Because the employer can pay so little and expect so much out of the undocumented workers, the American workers can't compete.
Blackwell says standing by the American worker is a stance often misunderstood.
I think President Trump can help America understand that this is not a racist or anti-immigrant issue. It's about fairness and humanity.
For this couple, America meant a better life, something they say they found the moment they crossed the border. But now they fear losing it just as quickly.
We're not trying to take anyone's job. And we do what nobody else wants to do. We just want to work peacefully. Like, we're just trying to survive, to have a better life for us and for our children.
Pew Research reports Florida is one of the top six states in the U.S. for illegal immigrants.
Kate, thank you. And coming up on our roundtable, all sides of this contentious issue. When we return, we will be taking it to the trapezoid.
If you're only hungry for a slice of apple pie, why buy the whole pie? And you certainly wouldn't want to pay for an all-you-can-eat buffet. So if you don't use your cell phone that much, why get charged for a plan that's too big or even an unlimited plan? Luckily, there's still a wireless company that shares your values. Welcome to Consumer Cellular. Our average customer pays about $25 a month for everything they need. Many pay even less, as plans start at just $10 a month. You'll get a straightforward bill that's easy to understand with no surprises and all the attention you deserve from our friendly customer service team. No wonder Consumer Cellular received a J.D. Power Award for highest customer service. Plus, if you're an AARP member, you'll receive special discounts. It's easy to switch. You can even keep your phone and your number. So stop paying for more than you need and start your 30-day risk-free trial today. Call 800-297-5313, go to consumercellular.com or visit a Target or Sears store today.
Attention small business owners. Penn Funding announces the easiest and fastest business funding program, the Platinum Business Account.
We needed cash fast. Business is good, but this is an emergency. We needed some new equipment, and the banks wouldn't help us.
At Penn Funding, we like to say, yes, you're approved. With your Platinum Business Account, you could qualify for up to $50,000 or more. This amazing new business account funding program is so effective, you could have the cash you need in just days.
I called, spoke with an agent who pre-qualified us, and connected me.
Call now for your Platinum Business Account. If you've been in business for at least 6 months, you could qualify for up to $50,000 or more in just days.
I called Penn Funding and had my money fast.
Need cash for your business? Call Penn Funding now.
Call 800-658-3433. 800-658-3433.
Welcome back. As we said, when it comes to illegal immigration, President Trump is putting your money where his mouth is. Under the president's budget, $314 million will be allotted to hire 500 new Border Patrol agents and 1,000 immigration and customs enforcement agents. $2.6 billion will be set aside for border security, including construction of that wall, you know, the one that Mexico was going to pay for. Joining us for more on how it could impact the Suncoast is Reverend Russell Meyer, the executive director of the Florida Council of Churches, and the Lamb, president of the West Tampa branch of LULAC, the League of United Latin American Citizens, and Sarah Blackwell, an employment lawyer at the Blackwell firm. She is also the president of Protect U.S. Workers. This is one of these classic issues where really it depends on where you fall in terms of if you support what the president is doing, you are happy about what you've been seeing around the country, and if you're not, you're pretty angry about it. Sarah, let me start with you because I'm thinking of one of the interviews in Kate's story where the woman says, we are doing the jobs that Americans don't want to do, and I'm thinking about all the folks who are in the fields picking the vegetables that we go and buy, the people who are cutting our lawns and running the drive-throughs, and I'm wondering, for somebody who is supportive of what the president is doing, are those jobs being taken away by Americans? Because I don't know too many Americans who want to do them.
Well, I believe that if you paid people a fair wage and treated them properly, then more Americans would be willing to do the jobs. But even if that's not true, what makes us say, okay, we have jobs that we won't do, so we're going to make you do it, and we're going to let you do it? We are now making them second-class citizens by saying, you get to do our grunt work, because we're not willing to do our grunt work. It's a message to both sides that is very inhumane. So I do not agree with that rhetoric of,
I'm doing jobs nobody else will do. Well, that's wrong on both sides. It's hurtful for both sides. The message to both sides is pretty brutal. I think the business owners are the only people who benefit from allowing immigrants to stay here illegally without deporting them and without allowing them to be legal and work legally.
You know, there is a point there, and I've done so many stories about day laborers, and I have seen landscape companies or construction companies pull up to areas on a street corner and pick these people up and take them to work sites. And you know, those business owners are not paying labor taxes and workers' compensation taxes. Aren't those the folks who are really at fault here?
Well, I think that many of those taxes are being paid. They don't get accrued to the worker, but the taxes in many cases do get paid. So one of the things we have to be clear about is since 2000, we've created a need for over a million agricultural jobs in the U.S. alone, for which we don't have a workforce for. So if you like to buy vegetables at the local grocery store, then you have to look at who's picking those, and we don't have a labor force for that. So if you follow the law of supply and demand, we have pulled workers from elsewhere. The problem is we have an immigration system that doesn't know how to account for that need. And so there were certain factors attached to NAFTA and the way it was enforced and not enforced that brought 11 million people into this country now, because there was a real need for their labor that was not being supplied from this market. It wasn't simply a matter of cost, wasn't enough or pay. There weren't enough people going around. When we had the hurricanes that went through the area, most of us got our roof put back on by this labor. The labor wasn't present. So now the question is, how do we do right? How do we create an immigration policy that's right?
Right. And Anna, I want to get you in here before the last break. How, you know, you work with so many people who are in fear of what's to come, you know, in the next year or so. You know, when they see the ICE roundups from around the country, what is the thought in the community?
Well, you can see the fear in the community. You can see and you can talk. And the worst thing is that we're bringing kids into this. And they are U.S. citizens who are suffering. And we're not talking about the kids. These are, you know, the community and the group that nobody's talking about. And we need to understand that talking about the jobs that, you know, they said that they're being taken.
And we're going to talk more about it. It just so happens there was a story out of Miami just from today, a woman who was rounded up by ICE in handcuffs and gave birth. So she may well be deported, but her child is a U.S. citizen. We are just getting started with our discussion. It will continue right after we check on our weather, so stay with us.
Although the financial crisis was some years back, it's still hurting many seniors today. But if you're a homeowner 62 or older, there's a mortgage program that just might make life a little easier. It's technically called a home equity conversion mortgage, but to keep it simple, let's call it a reverse mortgage loan. With the reverse mortgage, you can convert your home equity into cash.
We're not overwhelmed with paying the bills anymore.
And at the same time, eliminate your monthly mortgage payments.
We've got money in the bank.
You never give up ownership.
And smiles on our faces.
For your free information kit, call now. You'll have to pay your property taxes and insurance and keep up with maintenance, but you won't make mortgage payments. You'll receive money. For your free information kit, call now.
Call 1-800-634-1517 for more information. That's 1-800-634-1517.
Car experts and customers agree. There's a whole lot to love about a new Subaru. Subaru was named the 2016 Best Overall Brand, Most Trusted, and Best Performance Brand by Kelley Blue Book. And ALG named Subaru its top mainstream brand for residual value for 2016. Now you can lease a new Subaru Outback for just $229 a month or get 0% financing during the Subaru A Lot to Love event. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the 5 best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352. 800-290-0352.
We'll have more on illegal immigration coming up, but right now let's get the check on our forecast from Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Bob.
Well, Alan, here are the headlines for our weather tonight. Another cold night. We're looking at temperatures well below seasonal averages. Our average low right around 56 degrees. We'll be down about 10 to 12 degrees colder than that to start things off tomorrow morning. But by the afternoon, St. Patrick's Day looks to be pretty warm in the afternoon. In fact, the low 70s. We'll be back into the 70s. A beautiful day out there as far as the sunshine goes. We saw a lot of that, but highs were well below average in the low 60s only. And with a north wind, it made it feel a little bit colder out there throughout the day. We had wind chills this morning at 34 degrees at 7 o'clock in the morning. Well, the satellite and radar imagery is showing hardly any clouds around from Florida all the way through the Gulf of Mexico. We have some high cirrus clouds ripping our way, but they will not do much in terms of changing our weather. The winds have lessened somewhat, and they'll stay rather light throughout the day tomorrow. So not as windy tomorrow, and a little bit warmer should make for a nice comfortable day with very dry air in place. The dry air mass will cause for a high fire danger again tomorrow. Sarasota right now 58 degrees, and Venice now at 60 degrees, 62 in Bradenton. The high today, as I mentioned, only 63, official high. 76 is our normal high, and this morning's low, very cold, 39, 3 degrees shy of a record low temperature, and will stay dry for the next several days, all the way through much of next week. 63 in Orlando right now, it's 68 in Miami, 68 in Key West, and as far as lows go tonight, they'll be about 5 degrees warmer than they were this morning, but still a pretty chilly start to the day on St. Patrick's Day into the low to mid-40s up and down the coast. Well, for boaters tomorrow, the winds will lessen throughout the day. We'll be down to 5 to 10 knots by the afternoon. Seas running right around 2 feet with a moderate chop on the bays and inland waters. The tide's upcoming. Low tide will be at 10:49 and a high tide at 4:25 tonight. Cold again. Lows in the low 40s and mid-40s right near the beaches. Tomorrow, cool start. Mostly sunny and warmer. High of 72. The extended forecast calling for temperatures to stay pretty nice in the weekend as we wrap up winter on Sunday. We'll be right back after this.
For years, I told everyone my Craftmatic adjustable bed was the greatest until I got the new Craftmatic Legacy. It has an adjustable pillow feature that's awesome. You're going to want one too when you see how little they cost.
If you've ever had a bad night's sleep, call and price the new Craftmatic Legacy. It has so much more than other adjustables and still costs up to 50% less. Featuring a rising adjustable pillow rest, bedside power plugs, underbed nightlights, and more. Available in all mattress types with optional heat and soothing massage for as much as half the price of Tempur-Pedic Sleep Number and other adjustables. Enjoy temporary relief of low back pain, nighttime heartburn, mild arthritis. Adjust the rising pillow feature to help align your head, neck, and shoulders. See for yourself with our 30-day in-home trial. So call and price one today for less, up to 50% less.
You get so much more and it still costs less. You gotta see how little they cost.
Call 1-800-237-0214. That's 1-800-237-0214. Call 1-800-237-0214. Call now.
Are you considering joint replacement or revision surgery? Consider this. Dr. Edward Stolarski has performed thousands of successful joint replacement procedures and trained surgeons from all over the world. Using advanced technologies, Dr. Stolarski is able to perform some of the most complex surgeries.
I wish I knew about Dr. Stolarski much sooner.
After the surgery, I don't have any pain. It's like I've got a 16-year-old hip.
My name's Ed Stolarski. What I really do is I give people back their life.
Schedule a consultation today.
Credit card debt can ruin your life. If you owe $10,000 and minimum payments are siphoning away your paycheck each month, you can get debt-free in less time than you think.
I've paid $800 a month for the past 3 years and haven't changed the balance on my credit card.
Get Debt-Free Now has a program to reduce your debt, stop the harassing phone calls, avoid financial ruin, and settle for less than you owe.
I feel like a huge weight has been lifted off
my shoulders.
You're pre-approved for our special hardship program if you owe $10,000 or more. Upon payment of your new lower balance, your debt will finally shrink until you are debt-free.
My family no longer has 30 years of payments ahead of us at 20% interest.
There's no fees until you see results. So call now. Make one monthly program payment and free up your cash. Resolve your debt.
Call 800-628-1251. 800-628-1251.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, we are discussing illegal immigration and its impact on the Suncoast. Our guests tonight are Reverend Russell Meyer, Executive Director of the Florida Council of Churches, Anna Lamb, President of the West Tampa branch of LULAC, the League of United Latin American Citizens, and Sarah Blackwell, an employment lawyer and president of Protect U.S. Workers. Let's for a moment just go back to our conversation about wages and so forth, because Sarah, you said that that these jobs should be taken by American workers and employers should provide better wages. And if they did, there wouldn't be the need for undocumented workers. But of course, if you did that, the cost to consumers would go up and consumers wouldn't like that.
Well, I do not care what consumers would want or not want. I don't think it matters. I think when we abolished slavery, we said it's inhumane. And one of the bifactors of that is prices go up. I believe that not just Americans should get the jobs, but that immigrants should get the jobs at a level playing field as the Americans. I don't believe in deporting everyone either. I think that we have to find a system where immigrants have the same rights as the Americans to the jobs, and then Americans can compete better because they're being treated equally with the immigrants, and the business owners can't take advantage of the immigrants and not pay them their wages or treat them badly. Right now, it's a system of business owners making the decisions because they're hiring people and they're doing whatever they want with them.
Reverend Meyer, do you think part of the problem is that this issue has become so polarized? It was one of those hot-button issues during the campaign that a lot of people who are watching this broadcast right now, this is a black-and-white issue. They're illegal. They got to go.
The problem with where we are right now is a real loss of history to understand how they got here. What were the processes that got here? Most of the churches look at the issue from the question of family unity and saying, when you break up the family, you just create a greater problem in society that is almost uncorrectable. So family unity is primary from the church's position, and that's pretty much across the board and with a lot of other religions. So how did workers get here? Workers got here because there was a real need, particularly in the agricultural sector, and the agricultural sector has been outside of minimum wage laws, and minimum wage laws haven't kept up with the rest of inflation and everything else.
So Anna, if somebody is watching this tonight, and there are probably a lot of people watching this tonight, and they, you know, they are with what President Trump and the administration are doing, that, you know, they're saying, if you're illegal or came here illegally, you got to go. What would you say to them?
Well, we need to, like Reverend Meyer was saying, we need to see why these people are coming, okay? Because it was a demand. It is a demand there. And the American people is not fulfilling that demand. Right now, we are losing some farm workers are losing their produce because there is no way that people right now want to work sometimes in some farms. So we're inviting people to go and work over there and start, you know, doing the job that they are saying that they have been taken from. So they need to understand there is a demand that most American people don't want to do.
I'm wondering what you all think of this. Sarasota County Sheriff Tom Knight wrote a fascinating op-ed piece in the Herald Tribune today, saying basically right out front he is a conservative guy, a fiscally conservative guy, but he does not understand the ICE roundups right now. Basically, number one, he says, the broad use of prosecutorial discretion is troubling at best, and as I understand that, it allows the government rather than local communities to determine which illegal aliens are prioritized for deportation. In its simplest form, its prosecutorial discretion is allowing ICE to make up the rules as we go. Sarah, you know, what do you think of that?
I believe that it's We've had raids for many years. I mean, I remember years ago when President Bush was in office, he did raids. When President Obama was in office, although he deported more people than anyone else as a president, he got rid of the raids and did other things such as I-9 enforcement of employers. I believe that President Trump is building a wall and trying to secure the borders and focusing on the criminal illegal immigrants and trying to get rid of that. And then I don't see him pushing any further after that. I see him moving towards amnesty.
The reality is not that, because we have to be in the streets to learn who are taken, who are the people that have been taken. To this day, since the order has been out, we haven't seen criminals being taken. We have seen families, hard workers' families, be taken because it's not explicit to what extension, and the people who's doing it, they don't have the training to do it. So we're having families.
Let me offer up a scenario here, because one of the examples in this debate over the last few weeks has been, I believe it was a woman in Colorado whose only crime was that she used a fake social security number to get a driver's license. And I've done a lot of those stories out there, and the problem with, if you are getting a driver's license under those circumstances, you're not mostly being insured legally, so God forbid you get into a traffic accident, you have uninsured drivers. Isn't that a legitimate concern or a legitimate violation of the law that that people, when they hear about, Reverend, get very upset about?
Well, I understand why they get upset about it, but let's look. If you got a hole and you keep digging, the hole gets deeper. So we have a situation which We have these families here. Many have been here 10, 20 years. They have extensive family systems. If we break up that family systems, then we have orphan children. So what's the outcome of orphan children in this society? Not good, really bad. When we look at the larger picture, during this period of immigration growth, actually the crime rate has gone down, and the real there's a correlation that some people are beginning to draw with the fact that the increased immigration, including undocumented immigration, has actually driven the crime rate lower because of the strong sense of family unity within these people. So the notion that they should be criminalized, and this conversation about them being criminals, is a false news. It's not true.
Let me ask two quick questions. What people have seen on television, the word that has gone out, you had the Secretary of Homeland Security saying he would be considering separating parents from children. Since Donald Trump became president 50-something days ago, illegal border crossings have declined by some 40%. So in some way, is the rhetoric and the actions doing what the president said he was going to do in terms of stopping people from crossing the border?
It's really early to tell that. I know that that makes headlines, but what also has been put into effect was a series of moves that the previous administration did with Mexico and with some of the home countries that began to interrupt that happening along the way. So now it gets reported with this harsh rhetoric, and to make it look like the harsh rhetoric is working. However, if you just stop and think about it, it doesn't stop that day. That's a long process. It's a long journey coming up. So the journey's been interrupted 3 or 4 months earlier.
I'm going to give you the last word, but we only have about 30 seconds left.
Okay, so if I purposely, intentionally break a law, we don't live in a lawless land. If I'm starving and I have no food and I go and steal, I have a good motive for doing it. I'm feeding my family, but it doesn't mean that the law doesn't have to be enforced. When I speed, I know I'm purposely speeding. I could get a ticket, but the risk-benefit analysis that I make in my own head is that if I suffer, I know that I did this. So when they cross over or when they overstay, they know the risks.
All right, let's take a quick break, and when we return, we'll have final thoughts from our guests, plus what some of our viewers are saying about the turnout for Tuesday's election.
This March, Florida Studio Theater is presenting the play Brownsville Song, and our city will start discussions
on race,
on equality and civil rights,
the most important conversation of our time.
Will you join us?
ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. If you're only hungry for a slice of apple pie, why buy the whole pie? And you certainly wouldn't want to pay for an all-you-can-eat buffet. So if you don't use your cell phone that much, why get charged for a plan that's too big or even an unlimited plan? Luckily, there's still a wireless company that shares your values. Welcome to Consumer Cellular. Our average customer pays about $25 a month for everything they need. Many pay even less, as plans start at just $10 a month. You'll get a straightforward bill that's easy to understand, with no surprises, and all the attention you deserve from our friendly customer service team. No wonder Consumer Cellular received a J.D. Power Award for highest customer service. Plus, if you're an AARP member, you'll receive special discounts. It's easy to switch. You can even keep your phone and your number. So stop paying for more than you need and start your 30-day risk-free trial today. Call 800-297-5313, go to consumercellular.com, or visit a Target or Sears store today.
Are you paying too much for your cable or satellite TV? The U.S. government passed a bill mandating free over-the-air digital transmission of all broadcast network television channels. That means with the new TV Freeway digital antenna, you can get free HD programming from your favorite broadcast networks 24/7 without a bill. You just plug it into the back of your TV and start watching all of your favorite broadcast programs for free. There are no contracts to sign, no hidden fees, and no monthly fees. Just free HD broadcast TV. Take it with you anywhere. Call or go online now to get your TV Freeway stick for the incredibly low price of only $14.99. But wait, call or click now and you can get a second TV Freeway stick for a second TV. Just pay a separate fee, but you have to order right now.
Call 1-800-809-5196 to get your TV Freeway. Call now or go to tvfreeway.com. So call 1-800-809-5196. This offer's not in any store. Call now.
Welcome back. It's estimated there are more than 11 million illegal immigrants living in the United States. Since President Trump took office, illegal border crossings are at their lowest number in 5 years. Deportations are increasing and plans for a border wall are taking shape, if Mexico pays for it. What can we expect to go as we go forward? Our guests join us right now for final thoughts. And Anna, I'm going to start with you and speak to those who are watching tonight who they've heard the arguments, and it's very black and white with them. If you came here illegally, you need to leave.
Well, we need to understand that we're talking about humans. That we're talking about a moral issue here, that there is a demand, and we cannot deny that. And these people are coming to work. So we need to understand, and people are been coming, you know, American people are coming to our groups to give support because they are understanding and they are seeing, and people that are still opposing, they can come and they will see that it's not the way that it's been pictured, and Mexico won't pay for the wall.
Okay. Sarah, given that it's unlikely Mexico will pay for the wall, what do you want people to take away from this conversation?
I believe that we have laws for a reason. We cannot be a lawless land. I believe that people who overstay or come in illegally are breaking the laws with the knowledge that they may have to go back or that things could happen. I think that the way that the system is right now is worst case scenario because the illegal immigrants are being treated like slaves and the Americans are not being able to compete for the jobs and the only winners are the business owners. So I think that we need to allow the people to stay or make them leave, but we cannot allow the business owners to be the ones who benefit from this at the cost of everyone involved.
All right, Reverend Meyer, you get the last word.
Well, I would agree with what Sarah's saying about business owners profiting. So what the wall has really done that's there now and the bigger one that's planned is prevents people from going home. And they get locked up and put into detentions that are private prisons. And the private prison industry has flourished. It's like grown up overnight in America, and it's really big business. And its stock has really gone through the roof. And so the things that Sarah's saying is right on point. We need a humane, family-based immigration policy that actually treats people right, and we can do it.
All right. Thank you all. But before we go, we want to share with some of our viewers about what they are saying about last night's topic, Tuesday's election. Voters have picked two commissioners on Longbow Key. They also turned down two referendums on the Key. And we now know which three candidates will be in the runoff for city commissions in Sarasota and Northport. Voter turnout was around 20%, with the exception of Longbow Key, which had more than 50% turnout. We asked you whether you think that people should get more involved. Dan Koritsky writes, move the election to the same time as other elections. Duh. Pat McGrath writes, wonder if all those Sarasota residents voters feel are not snowbirds who vote elsewhere. And Zachary Davey writes, didn't even know when the election day was, and I think I've only seen two campaign posters, which so much attention is focused on what is going on in Washington. There needs to be a higher level of communication to express local matters. Just watch this broadcast and you'll find out. Let us know what you think about illegal immigration by visiting our Facebook page at facebook.com/news@7. And want to watch past roundtable discussions? They're available on Apple TV, Amazon Fire, and Roku. Thanks to our guests for being here tonight. Reverend Russell Meyer is the executive director of the Florida Council of Churches. Anna Lamb is president of the West Tampa branch of LULAC, the League of United Latin American Citizens. And Sarah Blackwell is an immigration or an employment attorney at the Blackwell firm. She is also president of Protect U.S. Workers. When we return, we'll have a final look at your weather, plus closing the gun show loophole. Florida Democrats are pushing for legislation to crack down on background checks for firearms. We'll have the details in our primetime headlines.
When severe weather hit the Sun Coast, ABC7 made sure you were prepared before the storm, as it made landfall, and in the aftermath. We were here for you, on air, online, and your mobile devices. The best Sun Coast coverage. ABC7, we're here for you.
I owed the IRS $10,000.
I owed the IRS $20,000.
The IRS garnished my wages.
They put a lien on my house.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency in the world. They do not give up until you pay.
I couldn't sleep. We were being audited. I called Tax Solutions Now, and a great big weight was lifted off my shoulders.
I called Tax Solutions Now, and they got the IRS off my back.
Tax Solutions Now had my wage garnishment lifted in 48 hours.
Tax Solutions Now can get you help. Our agents know the rules, can stop the pain, and get you the best deal.
We saved our home and overcame the most powerful collection agency in the world.
We connect you with a team of former IRS agents and tax professionals who get the IRS off your back.
Time is running out. Call Tax Solutions Now.
Call 800-303-9048, 800-303-9048.
Luxury for less at Alex Karras Lincoln. Drive a brand new 2017 Lincoln MKZ Sports Utility for $249 per month, or 2017 MKZ for $299 per month. We are proud to introduce the newest addition to the Lincoln lineup, the all-new 2017 Lincoln Continental. We have a great selection and ready for immediate delivery. Alex Karras Lincoln, affordable luxury, winner of the prestigious 2015 President's Award, serving Florida's Sun Coast since 1978. We're located 2 miles north of the Sarasota Bradenton Airport on US 41.
Are you Goodwill?
Yes, because when I donate
or shop at Goodwill,
I'm creating a job.
I am Goodwill, yeah.
Your primetime headlines are coming up in a moment, but right now let's get a final check on our weather with Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Bob.
Temperatures are starting to plummet once again this evening, already down into the 50s across the area. We are looking at this north to northeasterly wind component, and then it will become more easterly in time tomorrow, which will have a tendency to warm us up here across the Sun Coast by tomorrow afternoon. Now, tomorrow morning, it'll be a different story. It'll be chilly once again with temperatures dropping down into the low 40s. The winds won't be as strong as they were this morning, though, so a wind chill should not be a big factor, but it will make it feel a little bit colder if you're out there in the exposed wind. We'll have winds out of the east and northeast anywhere from 5 to 10 miles an hour. Well, the current temperature at the Sarasota Bradenton Airport, 58 degrees, a little bit warmer at the end of the Venice Pier right now. The humidity, 18% there. Winds out of the north-northeast at 8, and the pressure, 3029, and that is high, and it continues to rise. Temperatures statewide, 50s and 60s, a 63 in Orlando. It's 68 now in Miami, 68 in Key West, and temperatures around town, upper 50s in Cortez, Bradenton, Sarasota. A little bit warmer into Northport and Mayaca City right now. The Gulf water temperature continues to drop. It's at 68 degrees now. The temperatures expected for highs tomorrow will be below average, but we'll be back in the 70s at least. And it looks as though we'll see a lot of green in the morning in terms of temperatures reaching into the upper 60s by 2 p.m. But by 3 and 4, we'll be in the low 70s, and that'll be about it. The extent of the day, high temperatures anticipated to be right around 72 degrees. Cool conditions over the Northeast and the Great Lakes, while record warmth continues out west into places like Denver, Albuquerque, and Phoenix. Now, the overall picture shows a large area of high pressure continuing to dominate our weather. Looks like it will do so, too, right through the weekend. We are anticipating a gorgeous weekend. There is a weak frontal system which will approach on Saturday to the north of us. That will fall apart and won't have much of a chance of reaching us at all. And the weekend looks to be a little bit warmer, mid-70s to upper 70s for highs. The cooler weather in Toronto, Cleveland, and also into Minneapolis, all in the 30s there. 40 in Washington, 75, though, in Albuquerque, and 74 right now in Denver, making for a very warm skiing conditions out there. For boaters, east winds at 15 knots to start the morning off. Then they'll subside by late morning down to 5 to 10 knots. Seas running right around 2 feet and a light chop to moderate chop on the bays and inland waters. Water temperature now 68 degrees. Tides upcoming for Sarasota Bay. Low tide at 10:49 and then another one at 10:04. The forecast tonight, cold once again and a low of 43 degrees. The forecast tomorrow will start off chilly but warm up nicely in the afternoon. 72 your high. The extended forecast calling for great weather for the weekend. Sunshine as well. Spring officially arriving on Monday. Alan will be back with primetime headlines right after this. Stick around.
Although the financial crisis was some years back, it's still hurting many seniors today. But if you're a homeowner 62 or older, there's a mortgage program that just might make life a little easier. It's technically called a home equity conversion mortgage. But to keep it simple, let's call it a reverse mortgage loan. With the reverse mortgage, you can convert your home equity into cash.
We're not overwhelmed with paying the bills anymore.
And at the same time, eliminate your monthly mortgage payments.
We've got money in the bank.
You never give up ownership.
And smiles on our faces.
For your free information kit, call now. You'll have to pay your property taxes and insurance and keep up with maintenance, but you won't make mortgage payments. You'll receive money. For your free information kit, call now.
Call 1-800-634-1517 for more information. That's 1-800-634-1517.
It's the season of savings right now during the spring clearance event at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. Come shop the Suncoast's largest selection of new Jeep Wranglers or stop by today and drive away in a 2017 Jeep Cherokee for just $18,999. And for a limited time, get America's best value, a new Dodge Journey for as little as $16,599. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her so I could call and thank them. And she's doing fine. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
When you fall and cannot get up, an accident can turn into a tragedy. But with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast. Life Alert saves a person from a catastrophe every 10 minutes.
Life Alert is a lifesaver. If it weren't for Life Alert, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-652-3012. That's 1-800-652-3012. Call now 1-800-652-3012. For a free brochure, call 1-800-652-3012.
Now for your primetime headlines. President Trump is pledging to keep fighting for his travel ban even as more federal judges around the country block it. At the same time, he is facing questions over his unsubstantiated claim former President Obama wiretapped him. ABC's Maggie Reilly has the latest.
I do. Love Ireland.
President Trump's looking forward to St. Patrick's Day during the Irish Prime Minister's visit, but he's still having to look back, bringing up that initial executive order on immigration.
I think we ought to go back to the first one and go all the way.
After judges in Hawaii and Maryland are ruling to block his newly revised travel ban. Opponents say it still discriminates on the basis of nationality and religion. But President Trump calls the rulings judicial overreach, and the Justice Department says the ruling is flawed.
The danger is real, and the law is clear. And he will continue to exercise his constitutional authority and presidential responsibility to protect our nation.
The president's also left answering to those tweets he sent, accusing former President Obama of wiretapping Trump Tower. Now on Fox News, he shares where he got this information.
I've been reading about things. I said, wait a minute, there's a lot of wiretapping being talked about. I've been seeing a lot of things.
The White House says the term wiretap is really a broader term for surveillance. But with no actual evidence of either, Senator Patrick Leahy tells CNN this source doesn't cut it.
This is the president of the United States. He has access to all the intelligence in this country. He knows it's not true.
And now pressure is building for FBI Director James Comey to come out with exactly what he knows.
Director Comey, have you seen any evidence that President Obama wiretapped Trump Tower?
The leading members of the Senate Intelligence Committee did have a chance to meet with Director Comey. They released a joint statement today saying that based on the information available to them, they see no evidence of any government surveillance at Trump Tower. Maggie Rulli, ABC News, New York.
New developments tonight in the case of Markeith Lloyd, the Florida man who sparked a massive manhunt after allegedly killing an Orlando police officer. Governor Rick Scott has removed State Attorney Aramis Ayala from the case after she refused to seek the death penalty. Lloyd was captured in January after a nationwide manhunt. He is indicted on 11 counts, including the murders of his pregnant ex-girlfriend and Orlando Police Lieutenant Deborah Clayton.
To consider policy, not an individual case. It is my responsibility to make a determination of whether or not this is justice for this community, not an individual cases. There may be cases, even active ones, that I think death penalty may be appropriate because of the egregiousness of the offense.
The governor has appointed a special prosecutor, Lake County State's Attorney Brad King. Prosecutors like Ayala, as well as public defenders, could be removed from office under a new bill filed in the Florida legislature, a proposal giving lawmakers the ability to impeach state's attorneys and public defenders was approved by a House committee today.
I think that there should be more oversight and accountability, and I think this bill will fix that.
Toledo says her proposal targets no one in particular. A similar bill in the Senate has not been heard in committee. Democratic lawmakers are joining gun control advocates today, calling for an end to the gun show loophole. Currently, thousands of firearms are sold in Florida every year without a background check. A new bill would require any sale, lease, or transfer of a gun to happen through a licensed dealer. The sponsor of the measure says it is too easy for someone who isn't allowed to have a gun get one.
If you're a domestic violence offender, if you're someone with a checkered criminal past, if you're somebody who's mentally imbalanced, what are you going to do? You're going to wait and go to a gun show so that you can purchase a firearm and not have to undergo any background check. That is simply wrong.
Supporters of the legislation say nearly 40% of all gun sales happen online or at gun shows. Neither the House or Senate version of the bill has been heard by any committee. And that's all the time we have for this evening. I'm Alan Cohn. Thanks for joining us. Have a great night.